बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी इस शुभ सौगात हम सबको प्रदान करने के लिए।
आयुष्मान भारत के संकल्प के साथ प्रधानमंत्री जन आरोग्य योजना पीएम जय आज से लागू हो रही है।
Welcome, you're watching Reality Check. Ayushman Bharat or Modicare, described as the world's biggest health insurance scheme, has been rolled out. In theory, it's a great idea, a big push to make healthcare affordable to all. The scheme is meant to provide rupees 5 lakhs insurance covers to 10 crore Indian families, much more than previous such schemes. The government says it will take care of the insurance premium for all 10 crore families. But that's going to cost money. And one of the biggest points of confusion about Modicare and the focus of our show tonight is how much will it cost and where is that money? Sukirti Dwivedi has been crunching the numbers and she joins us. Sukirti, now just take us through what you found about trying to pin down exactly how much is this going to cost.
So firstly, in the budget, it was 2,000 crore rupees that was announced for the first year. But speaking to NDTV in August 2018, the head of Ayushman Bharat, the CEO, Dr. Indu Bhushan, said that the amount could go up to 6,000 to 8,000 crore rupees. However, this weekend, we spoke to the Niti Aayog official, Dr. VK Paul, who told us that the amount was actually going to be around 3,500 crore. This is what he had to say.
Now, we began with a certain amount, which was 2,000 crore allocated in the budget. We then asked for additional budget and we asked for 1,500 crore. It's available already. If no more is needed, more will be put in the budget.
While the CEO of Ayushman Bharat spoke to NDTV this Sunday, and this is what he said.
Right now, the issue is that we ourselves are not very clear how much money is needed, because we are doing this for the first time. And so in terms of discovering the prices, in terms of premium in different states, and since many states are going for the trust model, how much money they'll need over the year, this is not clear.
Right, Sukirti, so basically it's not clear whether it's 2,000 crores, 6,000 crores, 8,000 crores, or as the CEO just said, that they don't even have a figure yet. But even if one was to assume that some of these amounts are going to be the total allotment, what does that mean in terms of how much premium will the government actually be paying per family? Because I believe there were some questions over whether those are realistic amounts.
So at rupees 2,000 crore, which is allotted in the budget, the premium per family will come to rupees 200 rupees per year. If the amount goes up to 8,000 crore, as has been suggested by the head of Ayushman Bharat, this would increase the premium amount to 800 rupees per year. But experts say that even if we assume that the maximum figure is 800 rupees, it may not be enough. For example, Rajasthan's successful health insurance scheme has a lower insurance cover, which is 3 lakh rupees, but it has a premium of about 1,200 rupees per family per year.
Okay, so some questions about the premium as well. Now, Sukirti, there's been another aspect to Ayushman Bharat or Modicare, which is apart from the insurance cover, was their promise to rejuvenate India's very, very poorly run primary healthcare centers, which are, you know, they're calling them wellness centers. Now, you were pointing out that there were some questions even about the amounts allotted for that.
Yes, so there's also confusion over the funds for another part of Modicare, which is its promise to revamp India's ailing primary health centers. So 1,200 crore rupees has been allotted to these centers, and there are 1.5 lakh of these across the country. And per center, the cost would come around to 80,000 rupees. So even if we say that 4 nursing staff members are hired at one center at even a salary of rupees, let's say 20,000 per month for each of these members, this would exhaust this budget. And this, in one way, raises questions as to how Modicare will transform India's primary health care.
All right, so some serious questions there. Thanks very much indeed for that, Sukirti Dwivedi. Well, to try and get some answers, I spoke earlier to Indu Bhushan, the CEO of Ayushman Bharat. Mr. Bhushan, thanks very much indeed for talking to us. So, is it 2,000 crores? Is it 6,000 crores? Is it 8,000 crores? Or is it, as you said, we don't even know what the amount is?
Uh,
So what is the amount? Yeah. What is the number?
You know, of course, all of us are right in the sense that amount of money needed is a function of when we start the scheme and what are the assumptions. So right now, we are starting the scheme now. Mm-hmm. So we have 6 months to go. So if we had said any time that, okay, we need 7,000 crores because our assumption was that it will be 10 to 12,000 crores for the entire country, 60% of that goes from us. So that translates into about 7,000 crores from Government of India, right, for a year.
Right.
Now, we need the money only for 6 months. Hmm. So in that case, we need money, half the money.
Okay.
Right now...
So you're just saying that if you need half of 7,000 crores, then right now, for at least this year, you need about 3,500 crores. Is that right?
That's right. So 3,500 crores, but again, there are other ifs and buts because we are starting just before 6 months. And so the first tranche will go now, and which has gone to all the states who are starting. Mm-hmm. But the second tranche, which will be the second 6 months, will also be needed just before the end of the fiscal year.
Okay.
Because it will be 6 months from now.
But just to understand, you're saying just to kick it off this year, you need 3,500 crores. The budget has only given you 2,000 crores. So are you getting the balance 1,000 plus crores?
No, to kickstart the scheme, we need half of 3,500 crores. 3,500 crores is for 6 months. So we have provided money for kickstarting the scheme, but we need some more money towards the end of the year for the remaining amount. And we've asked for the money, and we will get that money. So actually, I've been saying that, you know. Money is not the problem.
Yes.
That's not where the constraint is.
Right.
And if you look at the whole budget, if you look at budget of the health ministry or health sector,
yes.
3,000 crores or 5,000 crores is a small amount of money as compared to what we spend. So I think money is not the problem at all. It's how to organize the whole scheme,
right.
How to get our hospitals ready, how to get the capacity to implement our scheme. That's the problem.
Right. We want to get into all of that at some later point. Tonight, we're just trying to focus on the financials of it. And one of the arguments being made is that even if you take the generous side of that figure that you've been talking about, 6,000 to 8,000 crores, the premium per family comes to only about 800 rupees a year, which many are saying are unrealistic.
Well, I don't know about your numbers, but my numbers are... Say, if we have about a premium of 1,000 rupees for 10,000 families, 10 crore families, it will be 10,000 crores, right? So
yes.
10,000 crores is what we've been saying. And, going by the range of premium that we've received, that sounds to be just right because most of the states have got premium which is less than 1,000.
Hmm.
And in some cases, it's slightly more than 1,000, but... overall average has been actually less than 1,000. So
okay, but
1,000
states. There are states, for example, Rajasthan, the cover is actually less. For a 3 lakh cover for the Bhamashah scheme, which is less than you, they're paying a premium of 1,200 rupees. And yours is 5 lakhs. But you say you can still do it with 1,000 rupees?
Well, you know, Bhamashah is a mature old scheme where beneficiaries know about this very well. But I would take another example of Nagaland, where we have received the quote of 444 rupees per family.
Hmm.
And recently, we've received JNK, which is 750 rupees per family. So
right.
What I'm saying
now,
is that...
Okay, this, no, the only point is, sorry, that some
like,
would say...
The
right.
initial exam...
Sorry, I was just saying that some would say that those are outlier states. Have you got quotes from any of the bigger states for premiums?
Yeah. For example, Jharkhand is less than 1,000 right now.
Okay, Jharkhand is less than 1,000. Now, just to take you to another aspect of Modicare, which I know that you're not directly involved with, which is this business of the wellness centers. And as you just heard, we reported that the figure that you've assigned, 1,200 crores for a 1.5 lakh centers, only works out to 80,000 rupees per center. Now, how can you hope to transform primary health care with that amount?
Okay, I don't look after that part of Ayushman Bharat.
Yes,
it's
I'm aware of that, sir. I just wanted to ask you in case you want to answer.
I was wondering whether you also have taken into account that 1.5 lakhs, 150,000 centers will be created up to 2022. So only 15,000 centers are to be created this year. So I think one has to take that into account because. I'm not sure whether the budget you're talking about is budget for next 4 years or budget for this year. Because this year, we are not creating 150,000 wellness centers.
Okay. But just to understand, are you revamping these centers or are you creating new centers?
Yes. I'm 100% confident that scheme is going to take off successfully. And I'm also fairly...
Yes.
I'm more than confident.
Will you get
that,
the money?
We'll get the money.
Okay.
And I'm also quite confident that these states who have not signed on yet will sign off sooner or later.
Okay.
Hopefully sooner.
Okay. Hopefully sooner. Well, we wish you all the very best because, like I said, we're all keen that this works out. It's just that, like, there are some questions that still remain to be answered. And to further answer more of those questions, I'm joined in the studio by Dr. V.K. Paul, member Niti Aayog, someone who's also been a key architect of this scheme. Great to have you back as always. Poonam Mutreja is here, Executive Director of the Population Fund of India. And also with us, Dr. Sanjay Nagral, surgeon, publisher of the Indian Journal of Medical Ethics, joining us from Mumbai. Let me just go to Dr. Nagral first before I come to my Delhi panelists, just to get you, Dr. Nagral, to very quickly react to what Mr. Indu Bhushan was saying, that are you convinced that his suggestion that these numbers will be worked out is something that we should take at face value, or are there serious questions just about a very basic aspect of Modicare that we simply don't know how much it's going to cost and how much the government is prepared to spend?
Yeah, Vasu, so the first thing is I'm a practicing surgeon and I'm not very good with big figures, crores of figures. But all I can tell you is that on an almost daily basis, I see patients who have catastrophic expenses. So any scheme, any good and well-intentioned scheme that is attempting to offer some support and relief to me as a practicing surgeon is welcome. Having said that, I think what we need to understand is that this kind of schemes have been in place in India in many states.
Yes.
So we have some lessons that we have learned from the scheme. Maharashtra has run a scheme for many years, originally called the Rajiv Gandhi scheme, now
yes.
re-christened to the Phule scheme.
Yes.
And I think what we need to look at is this scheme, to me, the scheme is like interim relief. I don't know whether Dr. Paul will agree, but it's sort of a tacit admission that we have partly failed in providing good quality healthcare, especially in the tertiary sector, in the
right.
public health system. So this is like a relief measure.
Okay.
What it is going to do to infrastructure, I think that's where the key is. Because if the driver is the state with a lot of money, whether they'll be able to change the patterns of practice, whether they'll be able to get more rational practice in, is I think the challenge.
Okay, let's take some of those questions to Dr. Paul and then I'll bring in Poonam as well. Let me just start by asking you about the second part of what I was asking him about, which is these wellness centers, because that's not something directly under his ambit. So maybe you could clarify a little bit on that. The idea that you're only going to end up with about 80,000 rupees per wellness center, which seems astonishingly low.
Okay, as Indu Bhushan ji was saying, that our commitment to convert sub-centers and primary health centers to the tune of 1.5 lakhs is up to the year 2022,
But what's the total amount allotted to that? Because the figure we had was 1,200 crores.
One moment. Yeah. So this year, we will do 15,000.
Right.
Okay. Typically, the budget for upgradation, an average budget, that has been generally kept as a ballpark figure, is about 17 lakhs for the first year of establishment, and then there's a running cost.
17 lakhs for 15,000 centers?
No, for upgrading.
For upgrading.
For upgrading each center, there is a ballpark figure of about 17 lakh that has been used to do the early estimates.
17 lakhs per center? Sorry, I'm
per center, yes, of course.
Oh, I see. Yeah. Per primary healthcare center.
Yeah, that's right. Okay. Part of which will go for upgradation of facilities, the civil work, as required, because some sub-centers and primary health centers will perhaps need nothing, because they may all, some states have done a good job. Others may have to be rebuilt totally, or better located if they are in a dilapidated fashion. So that's a number.
So now, just to understand, so 1.5 lakh centers into 17 lakhs.
That's over 4 years.
Over 4 years, but 1.5 lakh centers so 17 lakhs.
So 15,000 is what we will do this time.
Okay.
And in these 15,000, a large number of them, to begin with, will be our primary health centers, which are relatively better endowed to begin with, because that's our quick win.
Okay.
So
okay.
This
so that's
30,000.
Okay.
A population.
And then you will slowly build from there.
So the budget that you see is appropriate.
Okay, I'm going to go back and do the maths because my head is now totally spinning.
So we have done it for you.
Okay, you've done it for me, but I'm going to still go back and do it. Poonam, are you convinced that the numbers that are being talked about, and in fact we don't know what the numbers are because the goalposts keep moving, are enough to pull off a scheme of this scale?
The numbers are not enough because we are not only talking about 150,000 primary healthcare centers, or there were supposed to be sub-centers originally. But if the government acknowledges that they are going to do a small number of, as Vinod Paul is very rightly telling us, that it's 17 lakhs for only 15,000 this year, 15,000 sub-centers. Hmm. The impression that is being created is that overnight we are going to have a coverage of a large number of primary healthcare centers. Plus, what Vinod hasn't talked about is, Vinod, you have talked about preventive, promotive measures. You have talked about giving free medicines, free diagnostics. What about the cost of all that?
Hmm. Is included.
In 15 lakhs?
Okay.
In 17 lakhs?
Yeah.
It's not convincing, Vinod.
And
second thing, what about the insurance? What about the insurance?
Yes, coming
where
back to
is the
insurance.
Money going to come for that? If all the money is going to go for wellness centers, what about the budgets for insurance? And also, you know, as far as the insurance is concerned, there are many states which have had insurance schemes.
Yes.
And that's one reason they are not accepting the new scheme that you have nicely come out with. I feel that the learning from the insurance schemes, where huge amount of corruption in the private sector, which has come out in all the schemes, whether it's national or at the state level, all that has to be kept in mind. So finally, I'd like to say a huge investment in the public health sector, not just primary health care center, and you're a great public health supporter and expert. I would like to say to you,
let him respond.
Investment in not just primary, in primary health much more, but also in tertiary
can
health.
Can I just pin you down? I'm going to get you to respond to all that. But can I just first pin you down to a number though? Because I was trying to do that with Mr. Indu Bhushan and I couldn't get clarity. So what is it? What is the amount that's actually been assigned for premium? Is it 2,000? Is it 6,000? Is it 8,000?
Most of the states, it is a trust model, which actually means that the government and the state government, because they are in the opposition seat, have collectively made a commitment that this much population will be covered.
Yes.
Each family getting a certain cap of 500 rupees, and the services are encompassed in 30 packages.
Fine.
Period. Now, whatever it takes in a trust model will be made available. That's it. That's how it should be seen. Why are
but
we
is that isn't that is that how governments function? It's not a it's not a tap system that you say
mode.
I want, you know, two buckets or ten. You have to have some budget.
Agreed.
We have a budget.
What is that? I'm just curious to know what that is. I've understood the trust model.
Okay. It's a trust model is by and large what's operating.
But what's the number?
So in trust model, you make a commitment that it will be taken care of. That's
but
it.
Where will the money
Whatever
come from?
Whatever it takes.
Sorry.
Money will come for both from the center and the state. Typically
from the center,
in a ratio of 60 to 40.
So from the center, what's the projected commitment that you need for this scheme?
So the facts
scheme
are
for
that
this
you
year?
Have 2,000 crore allocation.
Yes.
Which was made at the budget stage.
Yes.
We, you know, looked at how the pace of engagement with the states was there. Then another 1,500 crore was made available. So we have equivalent of 3,500.
Okay. At the moment, that 1500 crores has been
part.
Given to
One
you.
Moment.
Yes, from the
central part.
Part. Okay.
And then, if you add, let's say notionally, 40% to come from the state, that makes a kitty of 5,500 crore.
Okay.
So that's a working number that you
but
should
that's
be talking
assuming
about.
Assuming the states have the money. That's
why when
the
states are signing and they are inaugurating and launching the scheme, they are making
are
commitment to the people that they have the
I
money and they put it on the table.
No. We are a very scheming society. We keep coming out with schemes, we sign off and we don't necessarily at the state
commitments
level.
Commitments made by the government on the floor of the parliament must be respected. Why are we not
I agree
it?
With you.
We
it
began
be
with 2000 because at that time certain estimates we just had to make
okay,
a
so you're saying
now we have a better picture.
At the moment
we
you have a kitty of about
funds. We asked for additional funds. Additional funds are available.
So
states have signed. They have agreed to put and we only have half the fiscal year by the way.
I know that. So for
and
half the fiscal year, Dr. Paul, for half the fiscal year, can I put down on paper that you're saying you have a kitty of about 5,500 crores?
We have a kitty of central government.
Yes,
so 2,500.
Yes.
Plus, states
hopefully
have to coming forward,
yes,
and that would amount to in a 60-40 ratio to about 2,000 crore.
2,000. So 5,500 crores.
That's what is already put
crores.
On the table
Good
by
thing.
The state and the center together on the table in that sense.
Okay.
As
okay.
A
so at least,
point.
All right. Okay. At
One
least
moment,
we,
Vasu.
At least we have a number. At least we have a number.
As we roll out,
yes.
You see, this is also. Please, things are. You know, into a new area totally.
Okay.
As we roll out, as we get better estimates, as we see the utilization by people, we will refine it. And by the way, why are we worried? We have a commitment to increase. No, I must say this to the people. This government has made a commitment to increase health spending from 1.2% of GDP to 2.5% of GDP over the next 6 to 7 years.
Right.
Okay. Therefore, there is an agreement, willingness to put more money for health and two-thirds
of that.
Let others
come in. Let
to
others
answer
come in.
Poonam's question.
Let others come
two-third
in.
Two-thirds of that. No, but I must say this. Two-thirds of the government money is committed to be paid for primary health care. And that
okay, now we must have others come in. We have literally very little time. Dr. Sanjay Nagral, you were saying that you think,
Vasu,
despite all that you've heard Dr. Paul say, you still think that this is half measures. You don't think this is...
So Vasu,
is the government going
it's
all
very
in?
Obvious. Yeah,
yes.
So it's very obvious that all the figures apart, there is also some optics here. There is 2019 coming up. But my take on it is that let there be competitive politics in healthcare. Rahul Gandhi went on record saying he wants to create an NHS-like model in India. Now, if we debate healthcare in India, I think it's a plus. It's positive because we are way, way behind the rest of the world. So
what's the one
a
thing,
debate around funding of healthcare
what's the
is,
one
is
thing,
a good thing
Dr.
for
Nagral,
India.
Dr. Nagral, what is the one thing that you would like them to do with Modicare, which you think has not been done? If you were to identify one big thing.
So I have a long wish list, all this money should also there should be infrastructural change, and we should try and use the state should use the power they have by to change the way practices in India, get in more rational practice, standard treatment guidelines, generic drugs, etc. And I think this is a big opportunity.
Okay, all right. Poonam, we have literally a minute.
Okay.
We have
I see
a minute.
This as a great opportunity to invest in the public health system at all levels. And two, I'd like to see this as a great beginning of a journey.
Okay.
This is not an Ayushman Bharat yet is not the destination. I think we have to learn from not just mistakes of the past. We have to do proper evaluations, review all along the way and add huge sums of money, not just what Vinod has been committed to. And the government is committed to him, but we want to see the evidence.
20 seconds.
As Sanjay said, in fact, the way the scheme would run, it leads us to affordability.
Okay.
Because this will set the costing benchmarks for the country, number one.
Number two, by the empanelment criteria and the audits will ensure that we have quality.
Okay.
And third, accountability, because we will make phone calls to our beneficiaries
right.
and found out how.
Okay, you've listed all three
so
points.
So accountability, affordability and quality will be stimulated and will be monitored.
Okay, wonderful. We hope we will hold you to that. But what I must say, conclusion, is that we appreciate the fact that you come on and Indu Bhushan comes on. There are very few government schemes and very few technocrats or bureaucrats or officials in the system who come out as much as you do to at least answer questions about this scheme. And that's something we really appreciate. Thank you all so much. That's all the time we have on Reality Check. Good night.